God does not create copies of anything. He creates authentic works. Each creation of God is unique. You are not a copy of somebody. God has taken the time and effort to mold you as a beautiful pot. And you are an amazing artwork of God. Your creation is not accidental. But you have been in the mind of God since the beginning of time. So God created you with a lot of goodness in you, and nobody can deny that. In today's gospel, we see the transfiguration of Jesus. Jesus took Peter, James, and John to the mountain and showed them his heavenly glory. Today, I want to give you a message based on the life of Peter. When Peter saw the glory of Jesus, he was so amazed because he thought that Jesus is going to establish an earthly kingdom. And that is what Peter wanted, an earthly kingdom that will save them from the hands of the Romans. But Jesus had told them many times that his kingdom is not of this world. So when Peter saw all the amazing things, then he said to Jesus, "Lord, it is good for us to be here. If you wish, I will make three dwellings here, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." But the same Peter who wanted to build three tents for Jesus in his glory left him alone on his way to Calvary. Moreover, he denied him three times. But Jesus knew who Peter was. There was a Matthew who knew very much about accounting. There was a James who was more courageous than Peter. There was a John who was a beloved disciple. There was a Nathaniel in whom Jesus found no deceit. But still, Jesus chose this weak Peter to be the leader, a leader who once knew the pain of denial, a leader who knew the pain of rejection, and a leader who knew the pain of unfaithfulness. Jesus wanted a person who is so innocent like a child. Jesus wanted a person who bitterly repents for his weaknesses. Peter knew that his life is the generosity of his master. He had said to Jesus, "Go away from me, Lord, I am a sinful man." And Jesus had seen his tears of repentance, and God counts every tear. Dear friend of Jesus, your life is not an accident, but a choice of God. Therefore, it is only God who knows the reason for your brokenness and weaknesses can love you with all your weaknesses and brokenness. Because God chose you as you are. If God wants you to descend from the mountain of transfiguration, that is the time of your glory, and climb another mountain of Calvary, then do not be sad in doing so. Because God has a plan for you, and that plan is for your good. Everyone has a mountain of transfiguration and a mountain of Calvary in their lives. A time of glory and a time of suffering. And we are called to be there on both these mountains. Therefore, we should not leave our friends lonely when they are on the mountain of Calvary. Instead, we should support them through our consoling presence. Let us pray. Lord, help me to recognize the goodness that you have poured into my life. Help me to stay close to you in times of joy and suffering. Give me a heart like that of Peter to be in front of you as I am. Amen.